Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to conclude our chapter. We are going to learn our last topic, that is muscles. Students, bones alone are not capable of moving the body parts, as we have learned about bones and our skeletal system in our previous class. They cannot move without the help of muscles. Means muscle is important fact. It is very essential part of our body. The human body has more than 600 muscles. Most of them are connected to bones with tendons. What is tendons? The tendons are very strong fibers that join muscles to bones and help them in movement. It means tendons are the most important part for movement. Tendons are strong fibrous tissues that connect muscle to bone. As we have learned about tissues in our previous class, that each tissue perform its own certain job. So tendons, it is also a tissue, and tendons are strong fibrous tissues which connect muscle to bone. Now let us learn about types of muscles. There are two major groups of muscles based on their nature. The two major groups of muscles are, first one is voluntary muscles and second is involuntary muscles. First of all, we will learn about voluntary muscles. Voluntary muscles work under our will. They are attached to the bones. Hence, they are also called skeletal muscles. The second name of voluntary muscles are skeletal muscles. And examples of voluntary muscles are arms, legs and hands, etc. The arms, legs, hands, etc. have voluntary muscles. That is why we can control our actions while running, jumping, walking, etc. So students, voluntary muscles works under our control. Okay, we can control over our voluntary muscles. Now, the next type is involuntary muscles. What are involuntary muscles? These muscles do not work at our will. We cannot control over them. They work without our thinking about them. Our stomach and heart are having involuntary muscles. What are the examples of involuntary muscles? Our stomach and heart, because they work round to clock without getting tired. The heart beats and the stomach digests food even while we are asleep. Means they work without any disturbance and we cannot control over these muscles. Let us perform an interesting activity related to voluntary and involuntary muscles. Divide a bulletin board into two halves with the headings, one side voluntary actions and the other side involuntary action. You just have to make two sections. Divide the class into groups and give them chits with voluntary and involuntary actions written on them. Each group is to identify the action and pin them up on the board in the appropriate column. Because we are not having our regular classes, you can do it. You can do this activity at your home. So students, what you can do, you can just divide the voluntary and involuntary actions and learn about them. Muscles are made up of cells called muscle fibers. There are three types of muscle fibers based on their structure. Now we will learn about muscle fibers. There are three types of muscle fibers. First one is striated muscle fibers, then smooth muscle fibers, and cardiac muscle fibers. Now let us learn about first striated muscle fibers. You can see the picture of the diagram of types of muscles: striated muscles, smooth muscles, and cardiac muscles. First of all, we will learn about striated muscle fibers. All voluntary muscles attached to the bones are made up of striated muscle fibers. They have dark bands running across them, as you can see in this picture also. Striated muscles. All voluntary muscles. Voluntary means which work under our control. Examples of voluntary muscles are arms, legs, etc. So they attach to the bones that made up of striated muscle fibers. Now, next one is smooth muscle fibers. Most involuntary muscles are made up of smooth muscle fibers, which are long and narrow at the ends. As you can see in this picture, smooth muscles, they are long and narrow at ends. These muscles do not have any bands. Organs of respiratory and circulatory systems have smooth muscle fibers. Means the example of smooth muscle fibers are respiratory and circulatory systems. These systems have smooth muscle fibers. They work for a long time without getting tired, right? Now the last one is cardiac muscle fibers. The word cardiac relates to the heart. That is why these muscle fibers are called cardiac muscle fibers. The muscles which present only in heart. These muscle fibers are present only in the heart. Therefore, they are called cardiac muscle fibers. They have dark bands like striated muscle fibers, as you can see the picture also. Cardiac muscles. Like the striated muscle fibers, they work quickly and are powerful. Like smooth muscle fibers, they are involuntary, means we are not having any control over them. They work on their own will. Strong and do not get tired. As you know, the example of cardiac muscle fiber is heart. And our heart works round the clock 24 hours without getting tired. That is why our heart works continuously. Now let's learn about working of muscles. What is the work of muscle? A body and its parts move because of the action of muscles. Muscle cells are the only cells in the body which can contract, means it can be shortened and lengthened, means can contract and relax. When required, we can shrink them and we can relax them, means it can be shortened and lengthened when required. The ability of muscle cells causes movements of the body parts. As you can see in this picture also, movement of fingers due to working of muscles. We can move our body with the help of muscles. The contraction of muscle cells causes a body part to bend at a joint, while the relaxation allows the body part to straighten again at the point. The muscles work in pairs to cause movement. They work in pairs and it causes movement. Regular exercise and eating a balanced diet make our muscles strong. To keep our muscles strong, we should take balanced diet and we should do regular exercise also, right? So students, now this chapter has concluded. Read again the topics we have covered up to and do checkpoint 2. All right? So this is for today. We will talk about our next topic in our next class. Till then, take care of yourself. Thank you all. बाय बाय।